ladies and gentlemen, gentlemen and ladies, we're going to talk about what's been going on all my life today. Casey and JoJo, with all my life, everybody. Hey, nobody does this.
Sweeter than me.
Ladies and gentlemen, we had it at 39 in the last video, and I just realized that was just a little too much for some of you. You can't handle it! So, I'm bringing it down. But here's the unique thing. We're not going to have the music for the most part of this video. I just needed an introduction. Hey, Casey and JoJo, thank you guys for the introduction. Oh, look at that. They're saying all their lives, ladies and gentlemen. They prayed for someone like me. Man, ladies and gentlemen, let's hit it this time. We have something we need to talk to you guys about. Now, I'm going to show you how fallible we are as people, including myself. See, I'm including myself in the fallacility. Fallacility. I just created another word, okay? Not felicity. Felicity, I ain't never met no felicity. Okay? I don't watch Arrow. I apologize, ladies and gentlemen. Felicity Holmes. Y'all know Arrow? Felicity? Arrow. If you ain't watched Arrow, it's a Fox. Not Fox, but
WB.
And so I would suggest you watch it. It's not a bad series. It's kind of corny at times. Kind of juvenile at times. But you know what? It's not entertainment. It allows the time to pass by. And then eventually they get rid of the Green Arrow. Black Arrow, the Blue Arrow, the Purple Arrow. They just make arrows all kind of colors these days, huh? It's the rainbow! Have a Skittle! Okay, ladies and gentlemen. There was a misunderstanding for a long time of Scripture by people. When I say Scripture, I'm talking about the Bible, God's Word. And the reason why there is a misunderstanding is because we're human. We can only think like humans. Sometimes we take things out of context. Now, I'm going to say that even I am liable for that. And I guarantee most of you were. But, even the people 2,000 years ago, 3,000 years ago, 5,000 years ago, had the exact same view, and someone had to come to set us straight. Let me show you something. This is Luke, the 13th chapter, and we're not going to read the whole chapter. We're just going to read the very first beginning. It says, at that time, what time? Pay attention. Some who were present reported to him, who was him, Jesus, about the Galileans, you know, because he was from Galilee, whose blood Pilate had mixed with their sacrifices. Pilate mixing blood with their sacrifices? So that means Pilate killed them, and more than likely during the Passover. Hold on now. In reply, he said to them, do you think that these Galileans were worse sinners than all the other Galileans because they had suffered these things? He says, do you think they suffered because they did something wrong? Ladies and gentlemen, because somebody experiences something bad, doesn't mean they did something wrong. For the most part, when people experience bad things, I'm just going to want you to hold on to this. For the most part, it's just Adam and what that idiot did. It's time and chance. There was a group called
Color Me Bad,
and they sang a song called Chance Don't It Bad. Well, they were quoting Ecclesiastes, the 9th chapter. You see, things happen because of time and chance. You give it enough time, there's a chance it's going to happen. Okay? That's pretty much how it is. Now, pay attention. He says, no, I tell you. Why? Because he had the authority, because he knew what was behind it all. But unless you repent, unless you change and turn around, that's what the word repent means, to change and turn around. Stop going in that direction. There's water. It's a lot of water there. You're going to drown. Okay. He says, turn around. You will all likewise be destroyed. Now, see, ladies and gentlemen, they use the word destroyed because that's where you see about somebody burning forever and ever in Scripture. It just means they'll be destroyed. You take a piece of paper, you put it in the fire, it gets destroyed. Just like the forest fires. No fire burns forever, ladies and gentlemen, because the fire consumes.
Well, the sun is a fire.
No, the sun is a chemical reactor. It is a nuclear reactor, not a fire.
Well, it looks like fire.
That's right. It looks like fire. The results are fire. But eventually, whatever the fire is consumed. So there has to be a reproduction in order to cause that fire to go on. If a person were to burn forever, that person would have to be tangible. You cannot burn, according to these people who think when you die, you become a spirit, and then God punish you by burning you forever. So if you were a spirit, how could you burn?
Oh, because it's a spiritual fire.
Well, spirits don't feel pain, people. Only humans feel pain. We have nerve endings. We have nerve endings. That's why we feel pain. Animals have nerve endings. That's why they feel pain. Trees have nerve endings. That's why they feel pain. Spirits are not tangible. We don't think on the same level, ladies and gentlemen. Pay attention. I want you to pay attention. Do you think? The problem is we don't think. We think we can think like God. We think we can think like God's Son. Pay attention to what he says again. Or those 18 on whom the Tower of Siloam fell, killing them. Do you think that they had greater guilt than all other men who lived in Jerusalem? No, I tell you, and before you go on, I tell you, the reason why these people died wasn't because they did something wrong, that they committed sin. Now, yes, they were sinners, but that's not the reason why they died. The reason why they died is they just happened to be in the wrong at that time. See, it's not the wrong place at the wrong time because there is no destiny.
Destiny? Oh, yeah, she had a child. Oh, yeah, I met her child. Oh, that child was, I can't say too much about that child. They done made her into a queen bee or something.
Anyway, ladies and gentlemen, he says, no, I tell you, but unless you repent, turn around, you will all be destroyed as they were. So he says they were destroyed. But then he says you will all be destroyed if you don't repent. Why? Ladies and gentlemen, he refers to those individuals dying who were sinners. We're all sinners. We will die. We are all subject to death. That is the one thing you can count on for being a sinner. The results of sin is death. Sin, in turn, leads to death, ladies and gentlemen. That's the whole point of sin, is that it's not sustainable. So I tell you, unless you repent, you will all be destroyed. Well, those who repent, they still die, don't they? Yes, but I got one more scripture. Sorry, y'all just want to bear with me. It's important. Well, technically, it's one more scripture, but it's probably three more scriptures, but all in the same cluster.
It's a cluster like stars, grapes, and galaxies. Oh, that sounds real neat.
We can go to Revelation. And when we get to Revelation, not shuns, but Revelation, or in some books they call it the apocalypse. Many people have misunderstood that phrase, apocalypse. And thus, ignorance ensues.
Ooh, what does ignorance have to sue somebody for?
Ladies and gentlemen, we're going to go to Revelation, the 21st chapter. Look, he says, and I saw a new heaven. Satan's been kicked out. He ain't there no more. His followers, his demons, have been kicked out. And a new earth, all of the wicked people, all of the sinners, are destroyed. For the former heavens and the former earth had passed away. They are no more. And the sea of wicked mankind is no more. See, go ahead. Let's go here. But the wicked are like a restless sea that cannot calm down, and its waters keep tossing up seaweed and mire. Again, the sea references wicked mankind. I also saw the holy city, New Jerusalem. It's not a real city, people. It's not a literal city. It is a symbolic city. It's what it represents. Coming down out of heaven from God, prepared as a bride adorned for her husband. The only bride, pay attention, in Scripture, in the book of Revelation, is the bride of the Christ. He is her husband, and there is a wedding that is happening. You don't believe me? Well, again, the Bible tells you what it means. You don't have to guess. Okay? One of the seven angels who had the seven bowls that were full of the seven last plagues came and said to me, come on now, and I will show you the bride, the Lamb's wife. Okay, so again, oh, by the way, pay attention about that new city. So he carried me away in the power of the Spirit to a great and lofty mountain, and he showed me the holy city, Jerusalem, coming down out of heaven from God. Okay, so again, symbolic. But let's get back to what's about to change. With that, I heard a loud voice from the throne say, look, the tent of God is with mankind, and he will reside with them, and they will be his people, and God himself will be with them. And he will wipe out every tear from their eyes, and death will be no more. This simply means no one will be dying anymore. Now, I want you to hold on to something. Neither will there be any mourning, nor outcry, nor pain. Angels, spirits, don't feel pain. Be anymore. This is an earthly thing. The tent of God is with mankind. Things have passed away. Don't feel no more. Now, hey, gives you a guarantee. Verse 5, he says, look. The one seated upon the throne said, look, hey, hold on now. I am making all things new. This ain't some little promise from man. This is a promise from me. I am doing this. Then he says, write this down. W-R-I-T-E. Write this down. Where do you write it down? In your heart. Why? For these words are faithful and true, or trustworthy. Let's see if this says, there you go, trustworthy. Now, wait, hold on now. I want you to understand. I did not know it was going to say trustworthy. I understood the context in which this was written. Okay. Why am I showing you this? Because these are the last days. There are certain things that are about to happen. Right now, I have been preparing for this storm. And it is a storm, ladies and gentlemen. Now, it's just reaching my area this morning. But the winds are something else. It literally destroyed one of my tents. Now, hold on now. You guys are going to learn something, so I would sit back and pay attention. It literally destroyed one of my tents that I used for storage. Ripped a hole right through one of its seams. And then ripped another hole through the seam right next to it. That's the amount of pressure that was on this tent. The tent ain't going nowhere. I got it. There's 20 gallons, 20 times 8. Ooh, that's a pound worth of water in containers. So that tent ain't going nowhere. It can blow all the other stuff. Not unless we get some the barometric pressure. I told everybody, I'm getting to the point, just hold on. I told everybody over the last couple of weeks, especially at the beginning of, well, the middle of last week, I told everybody I'm feeling very well. And I barometric pressure. And it leaves me feeling really blah. Blah, 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 blah. And with that feeling of blah, ladies and gentlemen, I know that the solar system is coming. Now, it may not be a rain event, but it's definitely going to be a weather event where the weather changes. This is the subject of this video. If you didn't know, if you read the title, you got it. But if you didn't start off that way. That's right. We started off talking about the preconception that everybody reaps what they sow, but not everything they reap is because they've sown. Sometimes it's just time, chance.
Darn, it hurts so bad.
Okay, you know, and it hurts so bad. So, ladies and gentlemen, this system right here, I didn't have to look at the news to see how devastating it was going to be. I'm glad I am not 300 miles to the north, because I would really be feeling horrible. I probably wouldn't even be getting up out of the bed. That's how bad I would be feeling. This happens every spring into winter. Well, spring into winter to spring and summer to fall. Every year I go through the same thing. It is a very, very trying time. And this is only as a result of, and I don't need your remedies. I don't need your suggestions. Let's just say it's my lot and I'm willing to deal with it. Let's see if we can get my water started, ladies and gentlemen, because my water ain't flowing.
Oh, you pregnant again, huh?
Ladies and gentlemen, this system is a hurricane, and they don't want to report it as a hurricane. Go ahead and look at that storm system. As a matter of fact, let's do that. If you guys don't mind, I want to show you that. Let's go. Well, that's the Federal Rules of Procedure. We're going to talk about that never. That's not for y'all. Come on now. Let's show y'all something, okay? Where's YouTube? Hey! Hey, you! Yeah. Get out of the way. I can't see the tube. Okay. So, we got a couple of things to talk about today, ladies and gentlemen. I just want you guys to be prepared, okay? We're going to talk about insurance, because that's necessary. We're going to talk about insurance, because that's necessary. But as I said, we're going to go to YouTube. So, give me a second. We can go to YouTube. I'm going to get there first. Ladies and gentlemen, I do want you all to understand something. This is highly unusual for this time of year. Doesn't happen often. If this was happening in any other part of this country, they would be calling it a hurricane. I want to show you. I have to pause you so that my overlay will start to get together. 1 second. Now, the first thing I want to show you is look at all of these explicit of what this is. That's because I'm trying to do too much. That's why they need to pause Casey and JoJo anyway. Come on now, Casey. JoJo, y'all still on that stuff? Come on now. Y'all got to work it out. Give me a second, ladies and gentlemen. I got to pause y'all to pause. What I want to show you guys is what this circle was before. And see, I don't have anything. See, I put weather California now. I don't have anything from the 24th. So watch this. We're going to put 10/23/2021. All right. I put weather in California 10/23/21. Because this is most of the moisture has already gone through. This is only the tail end. And just like with other hurricanes, they call it a cyclone.
a bomb cyclone.
We've been hit by a bomb, Mama. They say it's something dealing with a river and the atmosphere. Atmospheric river is what they call it. Ladies and gentlemen, it is a lie. And see, I said the 23rd. Now, this one is 3 days ago, but this is not showing the radar. This is just showing the radar. And I don't want that showing. I want the one, which is the same one this woman was showing. Okay, I want the original one, the one where it showed it was offshore and getting ready to come onshore, how they knew what was coming days in advance. Okay? And if you look at that circumference over water, that's called a hurricane. Category 1, Category 2, usually, when it's the East Coast. But in California, California doesn't get no hurricane. Ladies and gentlemen, hurricanes come up the from, what is that, Mexico all the time. Mexico has already had 2 hurricanes this year that I know of. Go ahead and take a look at hurricanes in California, and you'll see that it does happen. But I don't know of it happening that far north this time of year. And here's their excuse. They say it's happening because of the cooler waters. We know better than that. Ladies and gentlemen, hurricanes don't happen because of cool water. These weather storms don't happen because of cool water. Lord have mercy. But they knew this was coming weeks in advance. Now, see, you don't hear on the East Coast them calling it a low-pressure system. Okay, forecasting the impact of California's bomb cyclone. Okay? So, this is just to give you guys an idea of how they report things. But if you take a look at it, I saw the radar report, and I wish I had done the video when I saw it originally.
I wish you had done it, too. That way we wouldn't be sitting up here taking all this time talking about this. Look here, mother.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, the only reason why I'm mentioning this weather system is because all the other times when I was growing up, I lived in a brick house.
Ah, she's up. No, not that type of a brick house, you ignorant mother. I lived in the project made out of brick. We weren't afraid of no so-called earthquakes. We weren't afraid of no so-called hurricane in no brick house. We were the three little pigs, and we all huddled up in that one little brick house.
Why? Because when was the last time you ever heard of the project being hit by anything and not surviving? Y'all want to know the truth? I'm going to tell it to you. The projects weren't created for the black people. Projects weren't created for the Hispanic people. The projects weren't created for the Asian people. The projects, don't take offense to this because it is the truth. We'll do your research. The projects were created for the white people. You heard what I said. I'm not trying to cause no controversy. I'm just stating a fact. The people who lived in the projects first were individuals who were considered white. That's who they were billed for. That's what Franklin Delano Roosevelt touted. That's why they're called projects in the first place. It was part of the Reconstruction Plan. Remember, people, they had to provide a home for those Americans who volunteered to be a part of the New Deal. Let's make a New Deal. The projects were built for them. Now, how is that dealing with our subject? That deals a whole lot with the subject of our conversation right now. Ladies and gentlemen, we're going to talk about weather and storms. You see, I have a tent that destroyed on my property, and I have insurance on this property. Am I going to be filing a claim? No, I will not be filing a claim. Why? Because that tent. Okay? Tent. Placed
So I have the new tent. It's out there in the other tent. And it was replaced for it's a $300 tent. And ladies and gentlemen, if you're going to get a tent that is not that junk can't be out in the sun, because the sun has always done a number on vinyl. Okay? Just like, however, let's say it wasn't a tent. Let's say that that was actually my home. And let's say my home was actually made out of wood. You know, like Rapid's Delight, floating around something look like cheese. I say, oh, no, I got to leave this place. I can't stand what these people think. I don't care what these people think. I'm just sitting here making myself nauseous with this ugly food that stinks. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, let me explain to you, those who suffer as a result of hurricanes, those who suffer as a result of windstorms, continue to maintain your insurance. Most insurance policy says that they, pay attention, do not cover acts of nature. Pay attention. Most of them have a God clause. It's called a God clause. You know, like Santa Claus? Well, they have a God clause. And that God clause says that anything that is as a result of nature ain't covered. Well, ladies and gentlemen, y'all do understand that this is not as a result of nature, right? This is as a result of global warming. I don't care if you don't believe in global warming. The scientists have said global warming is a fact. And since global warming is a fact, it's man-caused, not God-caused. And so if you have had an insurance claim denied because of some stupid God clause, you better go back. Now you see how all of this comes together. Now you see how we get back to where we started. At that time, some were present and they reported to him about the Galileans whose blood Pilate mixed in with their sacrifices. Remember, Jesus could not be put to death on the Sabbath, whose blood Pilate mixed with their sacrifices. In reply, he said to them, do you think that those Galileans were worse sinners than all the other Galileans because they had suffered these things? Ladies and gentlemen, this is not nature. This is man-caused. Doesn't matter what you think about global warming. Doesn't matter if you think there is no such thing as global warming. The scientists say they are, and so I'm talking to the people who are denied insurance claims because it matters to them. And since they have officially declared global warming to be a fact, and global warming is caused by man, not by God, every that I've heard of to date has been listed as global warming. Ladies and gentlemen, I want y'all to pay attention to me, because some of y'all will not understand what I'm saying. Every single event that has occurred, that has resulted in tragedy, that has resulted in flooding, that has resulted in wind damage, has not been caused by nature. It has been, and all you got to do is find the report where they repeatedly say it was a result of global warming and all of the global warming initiatives. Go back, do an appeal of that original determination, and get your money. That's how I got the tents replaced. See, they have a God clause that they do not cover acts of nature. Acts of nature? This was no act of nobody's nature. You follow me, ladies and gentlemen? It works. I've done it myself. I know the insurance companies will hate me. Oh, God. And here's the thing. The court, what can they say? Absolutely nothing. Absolutely nothing, because this was not caused by God. It was caused by man. And so in my contract, there is no man clause. Okay? This was not an act of nature. This was an act of man doing. man caused this. And we have the scientists who have repeatedly stated that. Yes, they have an agenda. Yes, they have an agenda by saying global warming, global warming, global warming. They are making it seem like it's because of the cars. Yeah, they're producing too much pollution. The cars are doing it. Yeah, it's happening. The cars are doing it. No, it's not that man is doing it or their nuclear weapons tests in the upper atmosphere did it. No, it's not because of HARP or these other programs. No, it's because of man. Like I said, those of you who have lost your homes due to some event that was believed to be quote-unquote nature, all you got to do is go and pull up reports of global warming. Okay, watch this so that you guys get it. Hold on. Matter of fact, so it don't take too long, give me a second. Okay, that was another one of those intentions to put you guys on pause and not looking at the... That's why I keep this up, so I can see whether it's moving or not. And I didn't look down there. I was too busy trying to get it to do what it was supposed to do. And see, I put an E in Katrina because I am not... and it's Karina. So R-I-N-A. So I'm going to leave it the way it is because it ain't nothing. Other than me proving this point right here, I was going to do a Google search to prove it to you guys, but there ain't no reason for me to do that. Climate change includes both human-induced global warming and its large-scale impacts on weather patterns. There have been previous periods of climate change, but the current changes are more rapid than any known event in Earth's history. That's Wikipedia. Okay, why climate change is making hurricanes worse. Ladies and gentlemen, these are not natural events. Okay, so, ladies and gentlemen, I want you guys to know that a lot of people were not covered because they claimed it was God who did it. They wanted to blame it on God. Well, God cannot be charged with anything evil, ladies and gentlemen. And that's the first thing they were doing.
Well, it happened because it was God.
These scientists who don't believe in God call things acts of God, but they can't hold on to that anymore because they have been saying that these things are a result of global warming, climate change, not as a result of nature, but as a result of man. See?
Are known to be intensified by global warming caused by climate change.
See, this has never happened in history before because it's man. Okay? So, the reason why I'm bringing this to your attention is because, again, those of you who had insurance, you need to go get your money. Those of you who were denied this or that because of nature, you need to go get your money. And I keep saying that. Y'all need to get y'all money. Y'all need to start thinking for yourselves. See, my water's flowing now. Y'all need to start thinking for yourselves, ladies and gentlemen. Y'all need to start documenting. You see, right now, I took everything out of the tent that actually collapsed because I kind of knew something would happen. Honestly, I kind of knew something would happen, so I took everything out of that tent because that's the one I've been having the most problems with. Even though it was 30 and withstanding the wind all day yesterday, at night, that wind picked up, and we're talking about real wind, not that partial wind, not that any, many, mighty, mo wind. No, we're talking about real wind. So much that I went out there to try to stand up some of the tent is a collapsible tent. So I tried to stand up some of the sections. Do you know that wind was pushing so hard against that tent that it's no way on this planet? I am not joking with you. No way on this planet. I could have held that up. It was a fruitless endeavor. So now I do see those of you who go through windstorms, sandstorms, and all that stuff, and how you sit up there and you try, and you do the same thing I did. Oh, well, I'll come back and look at things after everything is done. And that's what I have to do. It didn't rain all day yesterday, although I was expecting all of the wind damage and rain damage to be yesterday. They said today everything would be over. We'd be just getting a little bit of it. Ladies and gentlemen, we've gotten so much of it last night that it was waking me up every single hour because of how the wind was. So, it just made me do the video a lot sooner. I've been thinking about doing a video on the subject that we've talked about today, because a lot of people are misunderstanding things. A lot of people are not realizing. See, when you grow up in the projects, you become what's known as a hustler. Now, if you don't know what a hustler is, go talk to Ice-T. He did a song about it. Like to hear it? Okay. Anyway, ladies and gentlemen, you learn to figure out how to get things done. Now, see, a hustler will do everything they can just before violating the law. So they'll do everything within the law, but they'll get technical with it. Seen it happen before? Nah, man, I just told you it was gold. Nah, it's gold-plated. It ain't real gold. I ain't never said it was real gold. I just said it was gold-plated. You asked me, was it 24 carats? And I told you, yes, it was 24 carats. Sitting in my refrigerator. You know, no, I told you it was 24 carats because it's 24-carat plated gold. But the rest of that junk is metal. Put it through a metal detector. I promise you it'll be going off every 5 seconds. Beep, 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 beep. You'll be sitting up there being pulled over to the side every single time you go to
the check-in station at the airport.
So, ladies and gentlemen, you guys have to understand, the courts are getting technical. Every single thing they're doing, when they are denying you something that you know that you had a right to, it's a technicality. You have to call them on these technicalities. For instance, I'm working on someone's bankruptcy appeal. That's why the Ninth Circuit Court was there. What, Ninth Circuit Court? Okay, anyway, don't worry about it. I'm working on someone's bankruptcy appeal, ladies and gentlemen. And in working on that bankruptcy appeal, let me let you know about the court. The other side said that the court said we had no standing because we didn't have a claim. And I wrote the court back and said, wait, no, hold on a minute. This woman was in bankruptcy, and the trustee still sold her property. The trustee didn't have any authority to sell her property. That means he acted outside the scope of his authority. And when the trustee acts outside the scope of his authority, he has no immunity. And then I put all that case law in there. Go read it for yourself. You know what I'm saying? And then I said, so if we have no standing, then why did Congress put such clauses in the law to begin with, if we had no standing? Why were there limitations on the trustees and penalties put in place should he violate his immunity? You see, a trustee has similar immunity to that of an arbitrator. An arbitrator has greater immunity. A trustee has total immunity when he acts within the scope of his duties. He's immune. Same as a prosecutor. Acts within the scope of their duties. But when they act outside the scope of their duties, that's where you come in and hit them across the head. Be like, get yourself back in that line. You know, that because they have a line that they must walk.
Dead man walking.
Yes, they must walk and toe that line.
I walk the line. I walk the line.
Johnny Cash, everyone! All right, we're going to let Casey and JoJo bring us on out of here, ladies and gentlemen. I just, by bringing up the bankruptcy case with the young lady, the courts were using a technicality, and the attorney for the other side was using a technicality. So I just basically told the court, showed them all the proof from our end, and just told the court these presumptive ignorance, they're going to have to come better, is what I was saying. Okay? I said it's not fair for them to sit up here and come at us with this junk and not provide any proof. And we're going to go from there. I'm not caring what the appellate court does, because that's the district court. I could care less, because we're bringing greater argument. By the way, before they filed bankruptcy, we did an arbitration. Yeah, I sent them the contract and everything. Show enough, Yogan. And then when they filed bankruptcy, I put the contract into the bankruptcy case. They wanted proof of claim. Do you know that when somebody files bankruptcy and they owe you money, you have the right to countersue? Well, guess what? The arbitration constitutes a countersue. You have the right to countersue. And it was an alternative dispute resolution. Now we get that information right out there in the open. That's what I'm doing. Oh, Casey and JoJo, I said y'all were going to take us out of here, and I'm going on past y'all. Hey, Casey and JoJo, everybody, they got to say goodbye. I got to say goodbye. Y'all have a good day. I hope this information was beneficial. Take care of yourselves, people. I'm going to take care of mine. Adios.